Hello everyone, here in this session we'll talk about working of centrifugal pump and its heads and efficiencies. So this slide we'll study about what is known as priming of the pump. Now here there is a sketch already you have seen. What you have to appreciate is here there is a sump from which the water is being lifted up. The water goes through suction pipe. Though the figure is showing that it is joining over here, the water is not entering at this particular point. It will be going straight into the center of impeller and then it goes up like that. So there is a delivery volume. So priming, it is a process of replacing air and filling of fluid or liquid into suction pipe, casing, delivery pipe up to the wall. So here there is a wall. So part of delivery pipe up to the wall, the casing and surrounding space of impeller, and also this particular part, that is suction pipe. So all this, in the beginning obviously there will be air inside that. You have to fill this space with the liquid that you want to pump. So that is known as priming. Unless the filling is done, you will not be able to start the pumping. So priming is essential. Now methods of priming, there is some manual priming which is usually adopted in small pumps. A funnel is used and there is an air vent. Actually there will be a provision of putting the water inside. Whatever air is there, that will be escaping out from a small vent which can be closed or opened. So that can be used for only smaller size pumps. If the pumps are larger, then there will be provision of compressors which are used to suck the air out. So to suck this air out, there will be a compressor which will be sucking all the air inside. Because of that, the water rises up into the chamber, scroll casing or volute chamber, delivery pipe and then suction pipe. Last one is self-priming. It is a special arrangement in which the pumps will be priming themselves. So overall, from this slide, what we want to know is priming is a process of replacement of air and filling up of fluid or liquid in suction pipe, in the casing and the delivery pipe up to the valve. So you can see that actually this is shown by the side. It is not so. Actually the water enters at the center of the impeller, and then when it is rotated, it will be gaining energy and then it will be trying to go with more energy or pressure up the delivery pipe. Okay, here working of centrifugal pump in this. Now we'll read. After priming, means priming is essential. After priming, with the delivery valve closed, the electrical motor is started. Now what happens after starting of the electrical motor? There is a motor. So the shaft is connected to the impeller. Now impeller starts rotating. Here it is, in this case it will be anti-clockwise movement. So it starts rotating. The liquid inside the casing gets centrifugal head. Now anyway, all this space is filled up with liquid because of the priming. When it rotates, it will be gaining energy and the water will be trying to go on the radially at the edges. Because of that, the pressure will be developed at the periphery, and because of that will be trying to go up. Pressure increases inside the casing, the delivery valve is gradually opened. Now, once the pressure is developed, gradually the valve is opened. The liquid rushes up the delivery pipe, moving radially outwards from the eye of the impeller. So once the liquid starts rising up, the water will be literally thrown out of these vanes. So it will be going away from the center radially. So there will be a vacuum created at this center, right? Creating vacuum at the center. The liquid gets sucked up through the suction pipe from the sump. So what happens is there is a connection of suction pipe there. So once there is a vacuum, the water enters from here to this point. Again, there will be a continuous rotation. So whatever water enters, it will be gaining energy and then it will be trying to go up the delivery pipe. That's how it continues to go. So without priming, obviously this suction will not be happening, or the head will not be created. That's why it is essential that pumps are primed first and then started. So this working work done on the water by the impeller, we'll discuss in the next piece of video.